You went too high, you see.
I see.
How do you feel about that? You know, idea that there's a kid serving 9 years in Texas for 2 marijuana cigarettes, but the vice president won only what they say is a fraction of the evidence they had against him.
I read the article in the Wall Street Journal also.
I got to start reading this
of the
paper.
Numbers of cases. They carried a very extensive article citing cases as the time served and the offense as against what happened to Vice President Agnew. Mm. Very long article. But that doesn't change the fact of what we're talking about around the country and trying to convince Congress of, and what California is already doing. A nonviolent crime first offender has no value of being sent to prison. And if you look at the last study that just came down 2 weeks ago by a committee that studied for over 18 months the question of imposing sentences, they said that no man should be given more than 5 years for any crime unless he was part of organized crime and made this his livelihood out of organized crime. And I continuously say, and I really sincerely believe it, that a first offender, which costs about $6,500 a year to keep in federal prison, and $2,500 for purpose of parole and custody on the outside, that he should first be placed into parole status and probation status, than placing him into jail where he commingles with fourth, third, second offenders who teach him, if he's young enough, how successfully to become a hardened criminal.
Yeah.
And by the acts of the guards and prison life,
I
makes him a hardened person.
I know prison corrupts, but wouldn't a guy be willing to take a chance on